गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, योर न्यू टॉपिक इज़ कैटरिंग एंड फूड सर्विस मैनेजमेंट. सो कम ऑन द फर्स्ट स्लाइड. नाउ स्टार्ट विद द इंट्रोडक्शन. व्हेन अ पर्सन लीव्स हर होम, हिज हर होम फॉर मोर देन अ फ्यू आवर्स, शी ही हैज़ टू सीक हॉस्पिटैलिटी एल्सवेयर. ऑफन इट मे बी अ स्नैक, अ ड्रिंक और इवन अ मील, बिकॉज हिज हर होम इज़ टू फार अवे टू गो टू एंड ईट. In a long work day, even if a person takes a packed lunch, he may want to drink some beverages. It may be tea, coffee, juice or an aerated drink. Thus, we require service that will supply food whenever and wherever necessary. These services are performed by the catering industry. The catering industry provides to varying extents a substitute for food that one would have got at home. With changes in the socio-economic scenario, food service and catering has evolved to an industry that is expanding, as there is much greater demand for food outside home, which is tasty, hygienic, healthy and aesthetically served. In some situations, there is a demand for food with long self-life. Scientific and technological advancement has helped those involved in mass production of food to streamline their activities, be more effective, improve the safety and quality, and yet make it less tiring. Use of computer and also contributed tremendously, not just for maintenance of records, accounting system, but also for online ordering of food. Information about equipment manufactured in different parts of the world and recipes for various preparation. So, what is the significance? Today, with increasing migration, urbanization, globalization, international travel, tourism, exposure to various cuisines and advertisement, as well as increasing interest of local people to try out new food, there is a demand of variety of cuisines and typically ethnic food. Knowledge of a variety of cultures and their ways of cooking is important, then people involved in this business need to have broad culinary experiences. Media, particularly television, has stimulated interest in cooking and the different food pattern of various cultures. Have you seen most TV channels deal with cookery and cuisines? In India alone, we have a very wide variety of typical cuisines, from Kashmir in the north to Tamil Nadu and Kerala in the south to the northeastern state. Odisha and West Bengal is the east to Gujarat and Maharashtra in the west. Food needs to be provided to people of all ages, in all walks of life, at any and all times in a 24-hour period. One thing is common to all, the need for food to be cooked and served well. Besides providing food at workplace, institution providing care for different target groups such as hospitals, old age homes, orphanage, hostels have developed. Other institutions where food is routinely provided, and school, college, office, prisons, feed programming undertaken by the government or voluntary sector to improve the health and nutrition of specific groups. So, service that cater provide food service are also known as catering services. Catering can also be regarded as a service that provide a pleasant change from home cooked food. People like to enjoy a meal, snacks, beverages that have been prepared and served in different and pleasant surroundings. More families are now eating out and weekends or go out to eat sometimes in the evening for pleasure. Also, many families increasingly travel away from home on holidays. They need to eat while traveling and throughout the holiday period in restaurants, hotels, etc., making national and international tourism and catering a growing industry. There are individuals or group who prepare food and send them to person at their places of work or to their homes. This is known as home-based food service. Such entrepreneurial catering activities are many. For example, take home meals, delivery of homemade meals. The demand for food to be catered is brought out by the large number of families where both husband and wife are working, and in some places where people live alone, have limited facilities for cooking or unable to cook for themselves. There are also mobile units that serve food. Provision of food, snack, beverages is needed in community activities such as fairs, exhibitions, fruit, flower, vegetable shows, where visitor would like to avail of some refreshment. So what is the basic concept? Food service industry is large and encompasses those places, institutions and companies that are responsible for any food or beverage preparation outside the home. These vary from expensive hotel and restaurant to less expensive outlets such as fast food outlets. Food services in canteens cafeterias in school, colleges, universities, industries, offices, etc. Food service management is the art of providing food and beverages aesthetically and scientifically to a large number of people in a satisfactory and cost-effective way. It requires a professional approach along with special skill, knowledge and vigilance at each and every stage in food service operation. Food service industry may also be referred to as catering industry. Food services is the practice or business of making, transporting and serving prepared foods. The purpose of food service is to supply palatable food prepared under acceptable standard of sanitation, aesthetically served at specified cost. So, food service manager is one who assumes responsibility for the management and administration of food service unit, department, organization. Menu compiling is one of the most important job in catering. All activities in the food service unit are influenced by the menu. The menu determines the ingredients required, the type of number of equipment, the expertise of the personnel and the number to the employee. So there are two types of catering services. One is welfare or non-commercial. Second is hotel and commercial catering. So first is welfare and non-commercial service. The major purpose of these services is philanthropy and social welfare. Personal organizations who undertake these services aim to ensure that people are well and properly fed, and if any profit is made through their business, it is of secondary importance. Example of such catering services are feeding people at workplaces, the armed forces in schools, in supplementary feeding programs implemented by the government, or for sick people who are in hospitals. Industrial catering is one of the welfare catering. Many industries provide food to their employees as part of their welfare activities. It is believed that work output is related to the welfare of the employees. Well-fed workers produce more and better work. Workers receive free food or food at price much lower than its actual cost, subsidies, which the rest of the cost being borne by the company. In industrial institution and welfare outlets, the objective is mainly to provide a necessary service. So second is commercial service. So service and establishment are open to the public and sell food and beverages primarily to make a profit. However, these services are valuable because they provide for the needs of their consumer as well as source of employment. Also, these services have tremendous economic significance to the country. Hotels and catering services support the tourist, travel and holiday industry. It is a major earner of foreign exchange since this industry brings money into the country in exchange of its services. Through the tourism industry, hosteliers and caterers indirectly contribute to advancing understanding between different countries. Styles and standard of function in catering by the commercial sector vary widely. At internationally famous 7-5-star establishment are elegant, luxurious, usually a large variety of cuisines are available, and the wingate manager has its disposal all the resources of skill and equipment needed. It remains highly skilled professional and is costly to provide and maintain. Prices at such establishment are always extremely high. Next is less expensive establishments such as 3-4-star hotels, restaurants, etc. have a pleasant and cheerful ambiance. The food and services offer high standard where cost and prices are less than at very top level. Small restaurants using minimum number of equipment and food is relatively cheaper. Menus may not be varied much, having Acuren oversells the types of food service establishments. It is also important to have some knowledge about type of food service system and delivery of foods. So, types of food service system. There are basically four types of food service system: conventional, commissary, ready, prepared, and assembly serving. First is conventional food service system. Food is prepared in a kitchen on the premises where the food is to be served. Following food preparation production, food is held hot or cold and served as soon as possible. The second is commissary food service system. In this system, food is prepared centrally at one place, but it is distributed to several remote areas for final preparation and service. Since the food production center and the service area are located in separate facilities. Third is ready prepared food service system. Food items are prepared well in advance before the time of service, are kept frozen until they are to be used in the large cities. Many such food items are available, example frozen parathas, samosas, cutlets, french fries, etc. And fourth one is assembly service system. In this, fully prepared food are purchased from manufacturers and only finishing process such as seasoning, thawing, reheating is done at the place of service. This operation require minimal cooking at the point of service. Example, sale of golgappas, pani puri and bhel puri. The manufacturing process is separated from the distribution process services. One of the limitation is that the number of item prepared may not be large. So, next is your menu planning. The success of organization is determined by the menu and how well the various items are prepared and served. A menu is a means of communication by which the caterer, food service unit, whatever type it may be, inform the customer, consumer, what food items are being offered. Function of a menu. The menu essentially performs two functions. It informs the customer or consumer about what is available and the catering staff about what is to be prepared. A well-planned menu reflects careful thought. It represents three points of view. First is the customer gets value for money in terms of the quantity of the food served, variety of the palatability, as well as way of food is served. The employees who have to translate the written menu into the actual food product, and the management who get satisfaction in terms of profit, good reputation, satisfied customer who will come back to the establishment. Next is management in food services. Management is a process of using resources to achieve goals through various interacting elements. Essentially, it involves taking decision in order to achieve goals. This we can also define management as a process of decision making and control over the action of human beings for the explicit purpose of attaining predetermined goals. This includes management of human and non-human or material resource. These resources in general are known as 6 MS, that is money, material, man, machines, minutes and markets. So management includes several functions, that is planning, organizing, delegating, motivating, directing, reporting, budgeting and coordinating the entire process. Let us briefly discuss each of these. First is your planning. This is a basic and crucial function. All other functions are dependent on planning. The objective of planning is to think in advance, determine clear objectives and policies, and select an appropriate course of action in order to accomplish the goals. Next is your organizing. This involves identifying the task of an organization and dividing it into two positions. And the jobs and tasks, each position demands grouping together workers of the particular skill and ability to gather in order to use human resource and other resource effectively and efficiently. Organizing service as a link between various other functions of the management. And next, staffing. This function involves employing and training human resource. It is important to hire person with the required knowledge and skill, so that the desired results are obtained in accordance with the goals and objectives. And next is your directing and delegation. This requires the skills and ability for making decisions quickly or an ongoing basis. Delegation involves distribution of workloads to appropriately qualified individuals and at various levels within the organization. Next is your controlling. This aspect is important to ensure that the performance is in accordance with the plans. This also includes cost control, which is very essential for financial operation. All items of income and expenses are to be monitoring and controlled. So, next is coordinating. The functions help in interlinking and interconnecting various type of activity for smooth running of the organization and achieving its objective. And next is your reporting. This requires keeping the different authorities of a department, example managers, executives, informed about the various tasks through reports, paper and records. This needs to be done to ensure smooth functioning. And last is your budgeting. This is important for all organization, including food services and catering unit. All activities are planned and undertaken keeping in mind the finance available. Budgeting involves planning for allocation and use of financial resource and accounting. So, next part is your preparing for a career. Persons involved in this industry also need to have knowledge about planning and establishment of physical facility for food preparation and service. Some of the personal skill essential to succeed in the food service industry are an interest in food and regular update of trends in national and international cuisines, ability to have a good focus on quality, production, sanitation and food cost controls, ability to establish, maintain and enforce consistently high performance standards, a friendly and outgoing disposition, good communication and international skill, ability to communicate effectively both verbally and in writing to an array of diverse internal and external clients. Next is your good organizing abilities with an eye for detail, pleasant, cheerful and energetic personality. Next, good command over English, other preferred language, especially foreign languages. And last is your ability to be on your feet for long hours. Next is your scope. Within this one vast industry, there are different kinds of jobs requiring different kinds of skill. Some who have the appropriate training may work in a palatial 7-star establishment with a luxurious atmosphere and come into contact with famous and important people of many nationalities. It is an international industry providing opportunity for trained person to be able to work abroad for some or throughout their careers. There is demand for well-trained, experienced professional who can participate in opening hotels and other catering establishments in different countries. Often hotels are in scenic and interesting places where people go for a holiday, providing jobs to the local on the one hand and giving opportunities to professional to work in beautiful locations on other if they so desire. Hotels and residential and restaurant serve only food. Restaurants vary in the kind of food they serve. Most departments in the catering industry are complicated, specialization requiring a great deal of work, dedication, practice and mastery. However, these are basic qualities that must be possessed by any young person who wants to embark on a career. So, next, career in the catering and food and service industry. In this industry, a person can work in various positions such as food service supervisor, cafeteria manager, catering manager, production manager, purchase manager and food service director. Assistant food service director placement can be obtained in independent restaurant, corporate restaurant, franchise restaurant, managed services in educational institution, healthcare industry, example hospital, industrial canteen, catering, services in travel related transport systems such as air, flight, kitchens, train, cruise, line ship. Persons who are interested in cooking, who have good culinary skills with additional and specialized training can work as executive chef, sous chef, chef tournament, station chef. Besides this, there are vast opportunities to take up catering independently. One can set up independent restaurant, corporate restaurant, franchise restaurant. So that's all for the today. Thank you.